But before, people used to give him money when he used to play the beam. Now Ma'am, and after having done the lesson, these children have done it on their own. I did not tell any dialogues or anything. Everything they have done on their own.
Very good.
So I really appreciate these children. And they are coming out with more activities on ants and on how to preserve the wild animals and all. Even those activities are there, madam.
Children, I want you to answer my questions, okay?
You find snakes in your school?
Yes, ma'am.
You have seen them? Have you seen them?
Yes, ma'am.
See, they are... Where do you all stay? In your house.
Yes, ma'am.
So, this is now we are very lucky. Surrounding our school building, you have a lot of greenery, isn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
So, plant yourself, or trees give us
oxygen.
So, we have rich, our air is rich with
oxygen.
That means we will not get any breathing problem or any health hazard because of polluted air.
Yes.
But on the other side, these things are also there. What?
Snakes.
Different types of insects. We see, we stay in the campus, no? We find different types of snakes. Sometimes I wonder, God is so great, He has created so many types of snakes. And every time we will not be able to know this, whether it is poisonous or non-poisonous, isn't it? If I ask the snake, now these children said bye, 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 bye. They said bye to snake charmer. But real snake can say, can it
no,
say
bye? No, ma'am.
Shall I share one incident?
Yes, yes, ma'am.
Okay. I said, what is all of you know, I think?
Yes, ma'am.
So, what happened, you know, once, long back, this was, I think, one and a half years back.
Okay.
A small snake. It was, I think, 1 meter long, that long snake. Thin snake, 1 meter long and thin it was. The snake was chasing a frog, I think. And our house door was closed locked. And there is a one mesh door also, that was also closed. But there was a small gap. And I think the snake was chasing a frog. It wanted to eat the frog. So what happened? It followed the frog. Followed the frog and it went to the veranda. Like we have a small veranda.
Yes.
So it went, now the snakes are capable of climbing up the stairs also. I have only 3 steps, but still in the snake climbed up the stairs, the 3 steps, and also the frog was leaping. But frog leaps and then jumps in. No? So frog was in the veranda, so the snake followed it, and the frog was going towards the door, the small gap. Snake also was going towards the door. And my son, that day he was at home, he went out, and then when he came back, he saw the snake. My son is not very small like you, he is grown. So immediately he just saw the snake, and then he called me and said, "Mommy, there is a snake near our door." So because it was near the door, he could not even go. So he was standing outside very far from that and then watching it. He was scared that it may go through the gap and enter the house. That time there was no threshold, threshold, you know?
Gadapa.
It was not there. Then what happened? I called Suresh Babu sir. I called Suresh Babu sir. Sir, like this, he has, is in the veranda, I think. My son has called me. So I and Suresh Babu sir went there. And you know what? And then with the help of the security person, Suresh Babu sir, just what did he do? You know, he was able to hit it. Hit and then, actually we should not kill. But there is no other way for us. Why did he hit it with a stick? Why did he hit it? Because if we don't hit it, it may get inside. inside the house. If it gets inside the house, then it will be very dangerous, isn't it?
Yes.
So, sir has it and then we removed it and then, but usually we do not
kill the snake.
But now, afterwards what happened? It was during holidays, few people were not there in the school. The school had holidays. You were not there, all of you were away. And a big snake again, this side where main entrance is there, no? Left side of the entrance, no, where we have the primary entrance. So there it was hiding. Then somebody spotted it and then they made noise. So immediately it came and then it came the other side. This side of outside, from outside, it came to the other side of the main. There are again grass and then we have plants on that side. Then somehow we managed to hold it there only. We called a snake. He is not a snake charmer. They catch the snake. There are some people who are trained to catch the snake. They don't kill the snakes. They catch, take them and then remove the fangs. That way the fangs are there. They remove the fangs and then leave them in the jungle. They don't kill. They are not allowed to kill. Like the governor has made an ordinance. So like that. So what they did? He took that snake. Was very long. And you know how they catch hold of the. Never tried these things, but he caught hold of the tail. The tail of the snake. And then somehow they have the knack. They pacify it. Then it was very aggressive. Somehow they managed to pacify it. And then afterwards slowly it was sent, like, you know, guided into a can. You know, can. It has got a small opening. So through the can, it was taken inside the can. And then they closed it and took it along with them. And recently, once again it has happened, it was in the month of, I say, November. So festival, Deepavali festival. So 13th, I think it was 13th November, 12th November. 12th November, that's a Chaturthi. So I was, that holiday, we all had holiday. Your people were celebrating Deepavali at home. I was at home and I was cooking. At around 12 o'clock, my son, younger son, he was there with me. So what happened, there was a power breakdown. So he thought there may be some problem with the main switch. So he, in the veranda only the panel board is there, switch also is there. So he thought I would just switch it on. I was in the kitchen preparing some food and then he was. Suddenly he saw, he just opened the mesh door. First there is a wooden door and then followed by a mesh door. So wooden door he opened and mesh door he was about to open. It opens outside. So he was about to open a mesh door. Then he saw a big snake. Very big. Then he said, Mummy, there is a big snake. Close all the doors, he said. From back side also he closed the door. There is a very big snake. And immediately he closed the door. Then what happened? I came out. I saw the snake. Such a big snake. It is. It was longer than me. My height. I'm not joking. It's really. It was very. I'm short. Actually, I'm short. And that the snake was longer. And very big snake. Fat, healthy snake. So what happened? That snake came, but it had come like, it was coming like this, climbing up the steps, and my son saw it. Then when he said like that, immediately what did he do? He just climbed up the panel board. It's a bit high, it is around 5 feet high. So from bottom it climbed into that, it curled inside, went inside, curled, and then again it came back like this. Then outside, on a chair, we had some, in a box, cardboard box, we had kept some decorative pieces. I have got a lot of collection of decorative pieces, so there was no place to keep inside. So what we did is, we kept packed, all was packed in paper, everything was packed and then kept in that box. And that box was kept on the chair.
What did it do? It just went inside the box.
How much?
Like it came down, box was there, full open box. But decorative pieces were there, so it came down and then went inside and it was comfortably sitting there. The moment it went inside, rats, small mice, they started jumping out. So two of them jumped out and then they ran away. One was, I think, bitten by it, so it was unconscious. It also came off and then it was, and one more packet was there. On that packet it was unconscious. It fell unconscious, it was there. It was not able to move. Then what happened? I was in a tension. I was worried because next to that box is window. Window which opens into our dining room. So I was worried if suppose that it comes, window was closed but still, suppose somewhere if there is a gap, the snake can sneak through it. I was just worried. And in that tension, I was really worried. Everybody gets worried, no?
Yes, ma'am.
So, what to do now? Such a big snake, nobody can enter my house. Because it is in the veranda, after they cross that place only they have to come home. So my son, my husband, they had gone out. If they come also, came also, they could not have entered the house. And what to do? I could not go out. I could go out from the back side. But still, nobody would dare, no? If you see such a big snake one side, the other side also you will not be, everywhere you will be worried. So what happened? I have one, the address of the, that is phone number of the person who usually catches the snakes. So I called him. Because of the tension, I was not able to get his number. I was handling the mobile, I was trying to find out his number, I did not get the number. Then finally, my son told, "Mommy, cool down. The snake is comfortably sitting over there. It is eating all the mice. So don't get panicky. Just try to find the number." So finally, I managed to get the number. I had noted down in my diary. I remembered and called him. Then he came after 1 hour. Then that we have what?
The snake was there.
It was there only because we were standing continuously making noise. So if everything the surrounding area if it was silent, then it would go out. So because we were making noise and then like just all the time watching it, so it could not. It was trying to come out. It was peeping through, but we are making noise, clapping and then shouting, hitting with a stick, so it was getting inside. So then finally what happened? After 1 hour, that person came. And what he did? He removed everything and finally it came. Such a big snake. He tried to...
Like anaconda?
Not anaconda, but it's wild, no? This is jungle. They get lot of food to eat. In the city, nothing. Even the city, like we people, the snakes, everything would be like, no? Weak and then weak. But this snake, a very healthy snake, big, it was this thick. And then, you know, I told her how much, around almost 5.5 feet or 6 feet high it was. So he tried to catch it by the tail. But it was trying to. Because such a big one and he was shorter. That fellow, he was shorter than me. So the snake is so tall. So it was trying to bite him. That is, it was hissing and then it was trying to bite him. But somehow, and it slipped off from his hand. And it was going away again in the jungle. But in between, in front of my house, there is a tar area of tar, you know. The black one.
Yes.
So it was going through the immediately he held it by the tail and then somehow he pacified it. They do something, then it becomes cool. Then I gave him a bottle, you know, bottle. No, he took a bag. I gave him a bag. So in a bag, you know, gummy bag, he just guided it and he went inside the gummy bag. He just tied it. And then where did he put it? He came in on a motorbike. So in the motorbike pouch is there. No, in that pouch he kept that. There I am. And he took away. time I will find any snake which is inside, we pay 350 rupees for that. Whenever he captures his snake, I give 350. Because we have to pay the charge. And the snake is not, it is not clear, and also we are also. Only thing is, dear children, whenever you play, you are a primary children, you go to the jungle side, you go to the children's park, and you keep on playing. When you are playing, you are not aware, you are not conscious about your surroundings, isn't it? So don't ever go towards the jungle. Suppose somebody comes to your house, do you like them? Suddenly somebody, some stranger enters your house, do you like them?
No.
And suppose a dog enters your house, do you like the dog? What do? You chase it and then you just try to hurt it, isn't it? Similarly, that is their evil. Where will they go? They have made their home there. And if you go there, where will they go then? You want your house, you want your school, and even in jungle also you want. Then where will the animals go? They don't have any place to go, no? So it is their area. You people, please don't go there. Okay? Why? First, it is for your safety. See, you can be disciplined. Can you be disciplined or not? But can I ask a snake to be disciplined?
No.
Still they are disciplined. You people are indisciplined, you go into the jungle. But snakes usually don't come out. They are disciplined only, no? They remain in that area only. Yes or no?
Yes.
So all the animals in nature, they are disciplined only. Unless we trouble, they do not break the discipline. God has told them. So they listen to God and they are well disciplined. So we also should be disciplined. We should not encroach on their place, and they also won't come to us. By chance, by mistake, sometimes they come out. Sometimes it happens, no?
Yes,
you get lost and then go in some other road. Yes. So that is, do you do it intentionally? No, it's by mistake. Similarly, snakes also by mistake chasing rat or frog. Now, for their food, the food is only meant. So for in search of food, they come out. So that time you must be careful. First of all, you must take care of yourself. Then afterwards, if any such thing is seen, don't try to hurt them, don't try to pelt stones at them. You should report to some elderly person who is available near the place. Okay? Okay? So I liked your class, children. Madam has been telling me, she is praising you so much. Children are doing so well. So it was like tempting. I wanted to observe the class. I want to be one among you today. So I enjoyed my class very well. Well done.
Thank you.
So I pray God that there should be snakes which always smile like you people. Snakes should be like you, smiling, but they may also smile, we do not know. Right? Okay, thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much.